Hi there, and welcome to this Alesis Drums tutorial. Today, we'll be covering how to set up and use your Alesis Nitro Max electronic drum kit with BFD Player. This process is virtually identical for both macOS and Windows computers, but I'll be sure to point out any differences. First, you'll need to register your drum kit's module in your inMusic account to have access to its software downloads. Check out the videos linked down in the description for full walkthroughs on how to create an inMusic account and how to register a product to it. Once you're logged into your inMusic account and your drum module is registered to it, on the product registrations page, click the plus next to View Downloads to open the Downloads menu. Under Software Downloads, click Free Premium Sound Pack and BFD Player Software. You'll see two download links for the inMusic Software Center, one for macOS and one for Windows. We'll use the Software Center to download and install BFD Player and the free sound pack that comes with your registration. It's also where any future updates for BFD Player can be easily downloaded and installed. Click the download link for your computer's operating system to begin downloading. Keep this browser window open and logged into your inMusic account. You'll need to access it again during the setup process. After the download finishes, on macOS, double-click the downloaded zip file to extract the inMusic Software Center application, then double-click it to begin running it. And when prompted, move it to your Applications folder, and the program will automatically start. On Windows, simply double-click the downloaded .exe file, and the Software Center will automatically install and open. Next, you need to log into your inMusic account in the Software Center to authorize and get access to the installers for your software. Click Let's Go, and a new tab will open in your browser. Since you're already logged into your inMusic account in your browser, click Continue, then Accept. And now your account is linked with the Software Center. Next, the Software Center will ask you to connect your Nitro Max's module to your computer. Be sure not to skip this step. You won't be able to complete the setup wizard or download the installers for your software without first connecting your module. Connect the included power supply to both the module's DC input and a power outlet. Next, connect a standard USB-B cable to the USB input on the module and a USB port on your computer. We recommend plugging the USB cable directly into one of your computer's built-in USB ports to ensure constant functionality. Unpowered USB hubs and USB extension cables may slow the rate of data transfer between the module and computer. Now, just press the power button on your module to turn it on. In the Software Center, click Redeem Software, and you'll be notified that your software has been successfully registered to your inMusic profile. Click Next. And on the next screen, make sure that BFD Player, BFD Player Core Library, and BFD Player Dark Mahogany are all checked so you have access to their installers. And click Done. So, let's get BFD Player and its core library of sounds installed. In the My Software tab, you'll see that the installers for both BFD Player and the BFD Player Core Library have automatically started downloading. The Core Library installer is a much larger file than the one for BFD Player, so BFD Player will likely download more quickly. Once it's downloaded, click Install, and follow the installation prompts to install BFD Player on your computer. Next, once the Core Library installer is downloaded, click Install to run it. While progressing through the installation prompts, you'll be asked to choose a location to install the Core Library's files. I'm going to leave this to the default location, which will create a specific folder for the core library files in Documents, BFD Drums. Again, the core library contains a lot of files, so installation may take some time. Now that BFD Player and its core library are installed, let's download and install Dark Mahogany, which is the sound pack that comes bundled for free with your Nitro Max kit. In the Software Center, click on the My Expansions tab, and you'll see that the Dark Mahogany installer has already been downloaded, so just click Install. Just like when installing the core library, you'll be prompted to pick a location for Dark Mahogany's files. This will default to creating a new folder in Documents, BFD Drums. Now that our software is installed, let's authorize Dark Mahogany in BFD Player. Open BFD Player, and just like with the Software Center, click Login to Profile. In the browser tab that opens, log into your inMusic account again if prompted. If you're still logged in, just click Continue. BFD Player needs access to your inMusic profile to authorize Dark Mahogany, so click Accept and wait for the confirmation screen. In BFD Player, you'll be prompted to authorize your expansion pack, so click Authorize All Products. And now Dark Mahogany is authorized and ready to use. You can view and manage all your BFD Player expansion licenses in the Licenses tab in the Settings menu. To browse and purchase additional expansions for BFD Player, check out the link down in the description. So, we have one last step before we can start drumming. We need to make sure our audio and MIDI settings are set up correctly. Click the gear icon to open the Preferences menu. Open the Output drop-down menu and select your desired audio output device. If you connected your desired output device to your computer after opening BFD Player, click Refresh, then open the drop-down menu again to select it. Once you select your output device, you can adjust its sample rate and buffer size if needed. The goal with the buffer size setting is to get it as low as your computer can handle. The lower the buffer size, the less delay you'll hear between hitting your kit's pads and hearing the triggered sound through your output. Under MIDI, you'll see Alesis Nitro Max in the list of input devices, so click it to make sure it's active. If you don't see Alesis Nitro Max listed here, make sure your kit's module is powered on and connected to your computer via USB cable, then click Refresh, then click it to make sure it's active. Click anywhere outside of the Preferences dialog to return to the main screen. Finally, open the Preset menu and navigate to Engine, Keymap. Then select Alesis Nitro Max to load your module's MIDI keymap. This ensures that all of your kit's pads will trigger their corresponding sounds in BFD Player. Now, the moment we've been waiting for, let's load a sound pack and start drumming. In Kit View, on the left side, you'll see all registered and installed sound packs on your computer. Click on the sound pack you want to use, and its presets will be shown below. Double-click on a preset to load it. Play something on your kit, and you'll hear the preset's sounds play through your output device. Each piece of the loaded kit is individually adjustable. Click on a kit piece, and its sound will play, and two menus will appear at the bottom of the screen. The menu on the left is the Kit Piece Selection menu. You can use this menu to swap out the selected kit piece with one from another preset. The menu on the right is the Kit Piece Version menu. Click it to select a different version of the selected kit piece if available. At any time, you can double-click a different preset to load it at a moment's notice. By the way, this exclamation point icon at the bottom of the window is a MIDI panic button. Clicking it will immediately stop all MIDI notes from playing. So, our kit is linked to BFD Player, and we're able to play loaded presets, but how do we adjust the preset's audio settings? On the main screen, click the Mixer icon to open Mixer View. Here, you have a plethora of controls you can use to adjust your kit's sound. At the top, you have four macro controls, which affect the sound of the entire kit. These macros will vary depending on which kit you've loaded, so experiment with them a bit to get a sense of how each one changes your kit's sound. In addition to the macro controls, below them are channel strips to individually control different elements of your kit. There's also a main channel strip at the far right to adjust the kit's main output. Finally, at the top right, there's a gain knob which controls the level of gain for the entire kit. If this master clip light turns red, or the tops of any of the channel level meters turn red, it means the audio is clipping somewhere in the signal chain. Keep an eye out for any channel that shows a red signal at the top of its meter, and turn down its fader accordingly to avoid clipping. So, now that you're equipped with the basics and how to use your Nitro Max kit with BFD Player, feel free to explore BFD Player further and how to use its functions in a way that makes sense with your specific setup. As always, for more resources and tutorials for using your Nitro Max kit with BFD Player, head over to alesis.com/support and bfddrums.com/support, where you'll find written walkthroughs and FAQs in each knowledge base, as well as portals to reach out to each brand's technical support team. Thank you for tuning in, and have fun exploring everything BFD Player has to offer for your Nitro Max kit.